That's happened. The Diamond Club, how's that doing, by the way?
Number four?
After the Three Shades of Grey.
Of course, yeah. Here it is.
That is so freaking awesome. You know the story of that, about this, Aaron?
No.
So NSFW decided that they were going to, they call it trolling, but I call it punking the Amazon romance list. And of course, 50 Shades of Grey has been, you know, tip top.
And this isn't just romance, by the way. This is top.
That's of everything?
Four of everything.
So the what they did is they made up a fake romance novel with just a blurb called The Diamond Club, because that's the name of the, you know, the special club in NSFW. And but there's no book.
No, there, it's 30. No.
There's 30 pages?
It's crowdsourced. So
I'm
the
sure
fans,
it's not exactly great literature.
It's not supposed to be.
But the point is not so much that you get the book, but the point
there's
is that you put
of,
99 cents in.
And there's a lot of banging in that book.
There's a lot of
banging.
The Diamond Club, getting back to the point of the matter.
So if you want to support them, it's 99
You have to buy
cents.
It. But, yeah. But by doing so, that's the only way you can vote, right?
Right. Right.
And the money, by the way, should go to a charity, but no. It goes to the NSFW Dragon Con Fund.
Right.
For good times for
and
all.
Parties, yeah. Open bar, hopefully.
Now, yes, of course, we'd like it to go to charity water or something important, but no, it's going to drinking. Let's face it. The honest truth comes out.
Well, also, a lot of women in Red Sonja costumes and a lot of dudes in 500 costumes. So it is going to very good causes, no matter what your orientation or area of interest.
And Dragon Con is coming in September?
It's the end of
August.
August, start of September.
So so hurry. if you don't have your Dragon Con tickets, this is going to be one hell of a party.
let me just put my own hat in the ring to be the Dragon Con correspondent.
You deal. Oh, well. I didn't even know we had a presence at Dragon Con. Not only apparently do we have a presence, but we have a massive party. Look at this.
And you don't
so
get to go?
Freaking awesome. Well, I nixed... for budgetary reasons, I
The Diamond Club, a novel.
A novel by Patricia Harkins-Bradley. Brilliant, by the way, that name. Brilliant. Now, let's see, can I zoom
in? I think you
in?
Can even click a sample and go in, and there's like an image from one of the chat realmers.
Okay, hide your eyes, kids.
It's, well, it's all
Oh, it's sent
text.
To iBooks on my device. Okay.
Oh, of course. And so that's a chat realmer called Gigaloop, named Gigaloop, who
Casey76 writes, "This book really pushes the boundaries of female sexuality. I'm only about a quarter through it, but so far it's great. It reminds me a lot of the 50 Shades series at times. It made me feel a bit dirty at times, but it's strangely kind of liberating. So far, a great read. You won't be disappointed." This is totally punking them.
Oh, yeah, totally. And then
what's
they
sad
covered
is
it.
That people are going to buy this.
So The Next Web covered it. And then also...
I saw
it
The was, Next Web article.
It was brought up on Veronica Belmont's...
you can't say the name of her podcast
thing.
Show.
Yeah, with Felicia Day and Veronica Belmont.
I can't believe they do a show called that.
I know. It's the internet.
I don't know why it says only 131 pages. This book is 250 plus pages, and for her first published works, Patricia Harkins-Bradley should be quite pleased with herself. This is so evil. God, is there going to be are there going to be repercussions? It doesn't say twit anywhere, does it?
No, but even so, people who wanted to buy the book for a romance novel, they get a romance.
They get
novel.
30 pages, and it doesn't say you don't get 30 pages. Oh, man. It says 31 pages right here, print length.
And that's
but
weird
it's a
because
small
it,
print. I mean,
It is like it was 200 pages when I got it in my iBook store.
Oh.
So, like, I'm looking at it here.
So that's crowdsourced 31 pages, which blows
well,
up.
Well, I don't know why. We actually think that's just a bug, that the 31
so
pages
it's actually,
that it
you,
says.
Is it really ghastly? I'm going to buy it. What the hell?
It's 99 cents. I mean, just. Here,
hey, a buck is a buck. Yeah, it adds up. Are you sure you want to buy and download Diamond Club, a novel?
Sure. Here,
really?
John, can you hand this to Leo?
Buy. Buy, buy. Is this the book? Is it
printed
out?
Yeah, that's the book.
Should we do a dramatic? I would like the audiobook rights to that. How much is that? I love her picture.
Right.
Patricia Harkins-Bradley is an English teacher, ex-wife, and mother of three in San Francisco.
And so the men that she romps around with in the romance novel, they're all really trendy jobs. So there's like a cupcake chef, the artist.
Show this.
There's it's all blown out anyway. There's a venture fund capitalist. There's
you know what? This is good. Let me just read the first few paragraphs.
Okay. Okay.
You bastard. I would have sworn the person next to me said the words, but they came from my mouth, my body, my soul, my right hand that dropped the price of the cup of overpriced coffee on my well-worn Converse sneakers. My left hand dropped my iPhone on the concrete, sending it dancing down the street. My iPhone. That's where I read it. Just a few simple words that changed my life forever. One simple push message that sounded the custom chime of my fully dateable app. Roman Dial is now married to Bonnie Barrow.
Married! Not engaged! Married! It had to be a mistake! My trembling fingers...
Oh, I'm sorry.
As if Snooki wasn't intimidated enough about her second novel, now she's got to live up to that. The bar has been raised, ladies and gentlemen.
You know, it's not, it's about as, it's a, almost, in fact, I would say better written, certainly a lot funnier than 50 Shades of Grey.
It will have, and the whole, I mean, it's very trendy. So
so it was a bunch of different people who wrote this? Oh, Justin must have had something to
Justin,
do.
I think, wrote...
This is Justin's writing. I recognize his writing.
He wrote the first chapter.
Yeah, that's definitely Justin's.
And then I believe...
Justin is actually a brilliant writer.
He's really good. There's
Roman Dial's soft hair bobbed back and forth in the golden rays of the San Francisco sun as I accepted his friend request between my alabaster thighs.
I don't think that was really...
Oh my God, that took me by surprise.
It's a romance novel.
What he lacked in a delicate nature as a lover, he made up in charisma. This is pure 50 Shades. It's so funny.
How many pages is on that?
234.
Right. So
it's just a bug.
We're confused, why it says 31
Well,
pages.
You know what? This way, no one will be disappointed.
Right.
It'll be like, wow, I got an extra 200 pages.
Right. And so we don't think that, I mean...
And so the Diamond Club is supposed to be an actual kind of sex club in San Francisco?
Right. So to get back at her fiancé,
she goes to the Diamond Club. I might have to read this.
And
holy cow. This actually is worth 99 cents.
Totally.
This is hysterical.
So that's the
thing.
Just
the first chapter alone is worth 99 cents.
Like, that's the thing. It's like, if you were into this and you got, quote, punked, you actually got
a 99
cent
book. Can I auction the movie
book?
Rights? Because I could sell them to Dana Brunetti. I mean, I'm telling you, this is a $1 million deal. I'm not kidding. This is huge.
Isn't it amazing?
This is huge.
Isn't it amazing?
That is really great. I am stoked. I was going to cancel that show, but I guess I can now.
They're going to be millionaires now.
This Week in Smut.
They could buy the Twit Network.
An X-Men fanfic. Phoenix versus Sprite. An early
Naked Came the Stranger. That's the one you were thinking about. Naked Came the Stranger. I remember that, yeah. Okay, so on the Gizwiz, that's going to be my turn the table turkey. And I'm going to do it completely straight. I'm not going to say a word.
That'll be great. That'll be great.
Dick, I know that normally romance novels are not the thing we review here, but because it is an iBook.
And it's only 99 cents,
And it's only 99 cents, I just have to tell you about a wonderful new book I've just read, The Diamond Club. Wait, am I doing it wrong?
No thumbs.
And then it flipped. There you go.
To be honest, I have never, ever, ever listened to an NSFW. Not once. Because I'm afraid of what I'll hear. I was on it, the first show. And that's the only time I ever heard it. I don't even know what this means. This could be...
Now you have a hit.
In Sicily, this could be saying, shoot me the next time you see me. I don't know.
Right.
The first buzzing in my pants denoted the arrival of the address which my paranoia would meet me. The second buzzing came...
You could write this, Andy. You should write one of these.
I just want to be the bad book on tape guy.
Yeah.
Who is not really reading or understanding the words, just making sure he intones them correctly.
Oh, there is a bad side effect to this. Because I bought that, look what iTunes Bookstore is now recommending.
Daniel Steele.
This is all I'm going to ever see on the iTunes Bookstore now is romance novels.
They know that they've got you hooked.
Oh my God, this is such crap. I can't believe it. This is what they're recommending. People who bought The Diamond Club,
like all of these ones,
really liked Daniel Steele's Friends Forever. Harlequin, oh my God. Entertain, enrich, inspire. I don't know about enrich. hot we new must, romance.
We must separate, princess, because you are highly born and I'm merely a rough-hewn bootblack. My grubby hands are not worthy of your porcelain skin.
You know, I have to say,
that's really
though,
good.
Most of these books are not expensive. They are pretty cheap.
Well, if you don't factor in the cost to your soul.
We also have one more thing, a book that we want to recommend everybody pick up. I know we mentioned and we mocked 50 Shades of Grey, but there is a better book now on the iBook store that everybody sure as heck ought to buy. It's easy to find because it's number four after the three volumes of 50 Shades of Grey. It's called The Diamond Club, a novel by Patricia Harkins-Bradley. Now,
and their job, everyone buy it today. I got to point out, get it to number three. We just have to beat one.
It's adult. Okay, I just want to emphasize, right. This is not for the kiddies.
You don't have to read it, just buy it.
It is, pay no attention to the 31 pages. It's 241 pages of very adult romantic fiction for 99 cents. And if you've ever been to the Diamond Club in San Francisco, if you've ever participated in the Diamond Club in any way, shape, or form, you know what I'm talking about. And I just think it's only on the iBook store. It's only available for a limited time. It's only 99 cents. Buy three copies. You'll
completely have
it. Oh, yeah. Leon looks under his
desk to find some crap to share. Oh, I like it. I found some really crappy stuff here. Says, let's fork away. It's time to table two. Now, I got to tell you, Dickie D. Hello.
Yes.
How are you? I got to tell you. This is something I don't think I've ever done an iBook. Have I ever done an iBook on this show? I don't think I have.
No, you haven't.
But this book is so exceptional. Have you read 50 Shades of Grey? Have you read that book yet?
No.
Okay.
No. I read 13 Shades of Blue.
Well, good book, but not a bestseller.
No, not a bestseller. No, it's not.
So 50 Shades of Grey, for those who don't know, is the publishing phenomenon of 2012. Three volumes. It's a romance novel. Basically, it's about a young girl who gets introduced to the ways of love by an older, very handsome, rich man. It's kind of the Sarah Lane story. And it's... It's very sexy. It's definitely not PG or R. It's not quite X. It's somewhere in between, but it's very sexy. But it is a publishing phenomenon. In fact, I just found out that my good friend Dana Brunetti, the Hollywood producer, just optioned that book and is going to make the movie for Focus Pictures Universal of 50 Shades of Grey, or Paramount. Anyway, Focus Film of 50 Shades of Grey. So there's a lot of excitement over this. And if you go to the iBooks store and look, you'll see there the number one, number two, and number three best-selling books on the iBook store are 50 Shades of Grey by E.L. James. But if you bought all three, it would be $30, Dick. And so my pick today is something that's going to save you money, because if you go to item four on the list, the fourth best-selling book on iBooks right now, it's just a fabulous book. It's called The Diamond Club, a novel, 99 cents.
Oh, I'm going to option that. You know what? I did option it, Leo. I was able to get the movie option for it for $4.99.
It is an awesome. Now, this is adult, very adult. I'll just read the description for you. It's by Patricia Harkins-Bradley.
She's one of my favorite writers.
Well, and she's a big fan of the show. In fact, somewhere I have her picture. I'll show you her picture because you might recognize her. But when Brianna Young discovers that Roman Dial, the man she built a relationship and a multi-million-dollar company with, has gotten married to another woman behind her back, she embarks on a journey to realize her dreams of professional and sexual revenge for everything she has endured at the hands of Roman. She goes to the Diamond Club, a San Francisco gathering of the Bay Area's most interesting and attractive people, from angel investors to airline pilots, world-famous chefs to dubstep artists. It is, according to this phony review, gripping and emotionally charged. And I got to tell you, if you just look at the cover of this novel, you will realize that this is, and there she is, by the way, Patricia Harkins.
Yeah, I recognize her. She always had this terrible 5 o'clock shadow, but just on the one side.
Oh, let me tell. Now, can I let you in on a little joke? There's a great story behind this. This was created by our show, by Brian Brushwood and Justin Robert Young of the NSFW show. It's crowdsourced. Now, I think Justin wrote the first chapter, but everything else has been written by the fans, 241 pages. The idea was they were going to punk the iTunes bookstore and sell it for 99 cents, and you notice they are now number 4. The only things beating this are the 50 Shades of Grey novels themselves.
Great.
And our goal, our only goal, their goal, I can't take responsibility for this. In fact, I think the lawyers would suggest I disavow all knowledge of this. Their goal is to at least beat one of those 50 Shades of Grey trilogy novels. So here's the deal. You got to go to iTunes. You got to go to the books, and you've got to order it. 99 cents, absolutely not for the kids. It is very romantic. It is perhaps the funniest book. I've only read the first chapter, and I was howling, especially if you've read The 50 Shades of Grey. It is actually a brilliant parody of it. It's very, very funny. And I just want to commend Justin Robert Young and Brian Brushwood for just 1,218 five-star ratings for this thing. I highly recommend it. But again, only if you are an adult. And don't pay any attention to the fact that it says it's 31 pages. I think it's actually growing. It's getting bigger. Even as we speak, it seems to be getting larger and larger, this book. It was started at 31 pages, now 241 pages. I think the sky's the limit. It could go, God knows how big this thing. It could get huge. So we want to make it as big as possible. You can help make this big. The chat realm deserves a lot of credit, absolutely. They wrote most of the book. And I have to say, it is hysterical. The money, I should explain, the money does not go to charity. The money goes to a party. They're going to have a big party at Dragon Con at the end of August, early September, for NSFW fans. And all the proceeds, and I've got to think they've raised thousands of dollars by now, if they're the number 4 book of all books on the iBook store, they're going to have some massive party. Wow. I mean, anyway, that's my pick.
I think that's super.